بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد. إن شاء الله عز وجل بني كتري ولم يكن في المنس. I just want to go over the sisters, if the kids can keep quiet for 10-15 minutes, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Today we are studying Surah Al-Ma'idah. Surah Al-Ma'idah is another surah, longest surah in the Quran, from the long surahs, and it is also Surah Madaniyah. As we said about Surah Al-Baqarah, the same thing. About this surah, it's the Surah Madaniyah, which is revealed after the Hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I will mention inshallah when it is exactly it is revealed. It has 120 verses. This surah, 120 verses. Al-Ma'idah means in Arabic language what we put for the, we sit on it and eating the food. That's called ma'ida, or sufra, or the dastakhan, what they call it in the Urdu language, or Farsi language mainly. That is the blue cloth that we put for a food. That is the one that we call it. It's called ma'ida in Arabic language. So why it is named by Surah Al-Ma'idah? It's named by Surah Al-Ma'idah.
Anyway, it wasn't clear about the site.
It's mentioned, it's named Surah Al-Ma'idah because what happened, the Christians, the Hawariyun, the close friends of Isa alayhi salam, they asked Isa alayhi salam to bring an evidence, a proof that he's a prophet, the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they asked him for ma'ida, that there will be a different kind of the food on it, and it will be a day of celebration for them. So they asked that the Prophet Isa alayhi salam to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reveal such a ma'ida, that will be, and it will be, there will be a lot of type of the food on that, and it will be a day of celebration for them. That was their what they asked for, and that's why it's mentioned, because of that story, it's mentioned Surah Al-Ma'idah. About the excellence of this surah, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu says that Surah Al-Ma'idah was revealed by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was riding his ride. So whatever the ride was, a camel or a horse or a donkey, whatever was that at that time, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was riding that, and the surah was revealed, and the ride that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had could not take, like it was very heavy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became very heavy because of the weight that the ride was not able to take it anymore. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took off the ride. He came down from the ride to make it easy for that animal that he was riding. This means that whenever there is a lot of hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that whenever the any verse or surah used to reveal, when the revelation used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba, they can understand that from his face. You will see that his face got wet, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started sweating. Because of the way, because it was very difficult for him, and sometimes one of the Sahaba mentioned that my feet was the under the feet of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that was the time that our surah was revealed. So it became very heavy, that Sahaba, the Sahabi, the companion was thinking that his bones were crashing to each other. It was that much difficult and heavy when the revelation used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Surah Al-Ma'idah is one of the last surahs that is revealed in the Quran. The number of this surah is, it's after Surah Al-Nisa. Surah number 5. In the writing order in the Quran. But in the order of revelation, it is almost the last surah of the Quran. One of the last surah of the Quran that's revealed. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the 7th year or the 8th year when he came for the Umrah and it was refused by the people of Quraysh, so they made the covenant, they made the contract between them that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will come next year for Umrah and will perform the Umrah. So when he was going back from the Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, from the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, this surah was revealed. So it's almost at the end of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Abu Maysara, one of the scholars of Salaf, he's saying that Ma'idah is one of the last surah that's revealed. There is no mansukh. It means all the ruling that is in the Surah Al-Ma'idah, they are established rules. And there is 18 commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the surah. 18 obligatory acts for a believer to do that. It is in this surah of Surah Al-Ma'idah. The rules and regulations that's revealed in this surah, it's because Surah Madaniyah, most of the surah is talking about the sharia, about the rules. So they are as follows. Number one, the rules of the contract. When you make a contract with someone, the uqud. Number two, the dhabaih, the slaughtering, the animals, and ruling of the animals that have been slaughtered. The hunting, the rule of ihram, the marriage with the ahli kitab. The riddah, when somebody go out of the freedom of Islam, that's called riddah. When a Muslim goes out of the freedom of Islam, that's called riddah. Ahkam tahara, the rules of the cleanliness, the wudu, and it's mentioned in the surah. The punishment of the stealing. And making a fitna in the earth, in the punishment of that, the fasad, bringing the fasad in the earth. The rule about the alcohol and the gambling. The rule of the swearing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rule of hunting while you are in the ihram. And so some more, these are the majority of the rules that Surah Al-Ma'idah is talking about. Also the surah included some of the stories like Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Al-Imran and Surah Al-Nisa included some of the stories about the prophets and the previous nations. It mentioned the story of Bani Israel, the Jews with Musa alayhi salam, that they told him that there was a place that they wanted them to go with him to fight. Then they said, "Idhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila inna hamna qa'idun." Go, you and your Lord fight there, and we will wait for you here. So that was the answer of the Bani Israel to Musa alayhi salam. Also the story of the two sons of Adam, the Qabil and Habil. It's mentioned in this surah, and what happened between the two sons, and that one of them killed the other one, and the fighting or the war that happened between the both of them, which is one of them is symbolically his goodness, and the other one is on the wrong side of the sharp. So this story is also mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah. I just wanna go back to the first verse of Surah Al-Ma'idah, but actually the first words of Surah Al-Ma'idah, which is Allah Subhanahu wa Taala mentioned. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أوفوا بالعقود How will you believe fulfill your عقود؟ عقود الجمع the plural of عقد. It is a contract. So any contract that you make with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or a contract between the two people, the two human beings, that whenever you make a promise, you have to fulfill your promise. Other than that, some of the promises, whether it's the promise of business, promise of doing something else, promise for any small or big things, it has to be fulfilled properly on the good side. Other than that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith that the signs of the hypocrisy is four. One of them is to not to fulfill. So because of the promise, like if they, if you do not, if you break your promise, that's one of the signs of the hypocrisy, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith. One hadith mentions three, and the other one mentions four quality of the hypocrisy. These are all over some of the rules and regulations that's mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Inshallah, Azza wa Jalla, by tomorrow, I will explain some of the verses in Surah Al-Ma'idah that's mentioned, and especially the end of the Surah Al-Ma'idah, which is talking about the Day of the Judgment, and that Isa alayhi salam will be brought in front of the all Christians, and he will be asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that did you told them to take you as a god? He will be asked that question by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. So did you told them to take you as a god and your mother as a god? This question will be asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Prophet Isa alayhi salam. And for sure the Prophet Isa alayhi salam will answer. Answer will be no. And we'll see what will happen with the people that they took Isa alayhi salam, or they believe in Isa alayhi salam as a god or as a ilah. These are the topics, and inshallah tomorrow we will talk in more detail about that incidents that will be happening on the Day of the Judgment. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.